Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, my dear students, here is your mathematics teacher Muhammad Al-Nasir from Pakistan International School, Saudi Arabia. Today we will continue our lecture number 54 and exercise 5.2, question number 2. And we have to solve one part out of 3 and 4. So here is part number 3. This is distributive property of intersection over union. Distributive property of intersection over union. That is A intersection B union C. Here is A intersection B, union A intersection C. We will take left hand side as A intersection B union C. A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Intersection B, 2, 4, 6 and 8, union C is 1, 4 and 8. Dear students, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and intersection. Union means to combine. You will write down 1 from here, 2 from here. 4, 6 and 8. 1, 2, 4, 6 and 8. 8 is double, so write down once. Similarly, 4 is double, write down once. So what is the intersection of both? Intersection means common members in both. So what are the common members? 1, 2, 4 and 6 also. 1, 2, 4 and 6. 1, 2, 4, 6 are present in both. This is your left hand side. After that, we will have right hand side. In case of right hand side, we have A intersection B. A intersection B, union A intersection C. Union A intersection C. Actually, I don't want to rub this because this was left hand side. This will be confirmation of your answer. Left hand side must be to the right hand side. That was left hand side. Here is A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Intersection B is 2, 4, 6, 8. Union again. A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and intersection 1, 4 and 8. 1, 4, 8. You can check from these two what are the common members. Here is 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6 are present in both. Union. Then what is the common in these two sets? 1 is common, 4 is common. Yes, 1 and 4 are common. 1 and 4 are common in these two sets. Now you take union of that. In case of union, you combine and write down all members, but double member will be written once. 4 is written one time. So you will have 1, 2, 4, 6. That is equal to 1, 2, 4 and 6. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. Dear students, I hope that you understood this question. After this, you can have question number 4, and there are two parts. Part 1 is given. Question number 4. Question number 4. In case of question number 4, universal X and Y, these sets are given and we have to prove that. if universal set is 1, 2, 3, up to so on, 20, x is equal to 1, 3, 7, 9, 15, 18, 20. 1, 3, 7, 9, 15, 18, 20. Yes, 1, 3, 7, 9, 15, 18, 20. And y is 1, 3, 5, up to so on, 17. So, dear students, we have these three sets. We have to prove that x minus y is equal to x intersection y complement. X minus y is equal to x intersection y complement. We have to prove that left hand side is the right hand side. So we write down left hand side as x minus y. What is x? 1, 3, 7, 9, 15, 18, and 20. Minus 1, 2, 1, 3, 5, up to so on, 17. Dear students, you can check. You will leave these numbers from here and remaining will be written here. 1, 3, 7, 9, 15, they are all present here. Only 18 and 20 left. So that was your left hand side. After that, we will find right hand side and answer must be this one. First of all, before solving right hand side, I am finding y complement. That is universal minus y. What about universal? 1, 2, 3 up to so on, 20. Minus y is 1, 3, 5 up to so on, 17. Dear students, from this universal set, we leave these members. We leave these members. So what left? They are odd numbers. And here up to 17, the even number will be recorded. Here is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 16. Then after 16, we will write down 18, 19 and 20. Remember that after 17, all members are present here. 18, 19 and 20. Now what about right hand side? Right hand side is x intersection y complement. What is x? 1, 3, 7, 9, 15, 18, 20. Intersection 1, 3, 7, 9, 15, 18, 20. This is x. Intersection y complement. This is y complement. Here is y complement. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 12, 12 are even, there is 14 also, because they are even numbers, 14, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, yes, 14, 16, 18, 19 and 20. Dear students, you will check what is common in these two sets. Definitely 18 and 20, here is. All others are different. 18 and 20. So that was your left hand side and here is your right hand side. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. Hence, left hand side is equal to right hand side. I hope that you understood this question. Exercise 5.2 finished. After this, exercise 5.3. Exercise 5.3.
Question number one. Basically, in question number one, you have seen that in the previous exercise, we did first part even. A minus B equal to A intersection B complement. That was X minus Y equal to X intersection Y complement. And you can see your part part number 5 and 6. They are also present in part number, in question number 4 even. We did these parts in question number 4. So dear student, they are exactly same. Part number 5 and question number 4, part 5, they are exactly same. Only sets are different. But in question number 1, you will solve simply by using their sets. And left hand side to be made equal right hand side. But in question number 4, we have to solve this question by Venn diagrams. So I am taking question number 4, part number 4. Question number 4, part 4. The question is, universal is 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, 10. And A is, what about A? A is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. And B is 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 8. First of all, dear students, we have to prove our part number 4 as that was A intersection B complement. A intersection B whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. That is part number 4. We have to prove this left hand side is equal to right hand side. By Venn diagram, first of all, you will check. We have the diagram of question. Remember that. This is diagram of question. Universal set containing 1 to 10. Then A and B. First of all, check whether something common in A and B or not. If there is common, they are overlapping. Remember that this is 3 and 5, 3 and 5 present in both. So here, A and B, 3 and 5 present in both. Here is 1, 7, 9, 2, 4, 8. And what left, which are not present in A and B but present in universal? It will be 6 and 10. So dear students, this is the figure, this is Venn diagram of your question. Now you have to prove left hand side and right hand side. First of all, we will take A intersection B. A intersection B means which is common in both. A and B, 3 and 5, 1, 7, 9, 2, 4, and 8. This is A intersection B. This is A intersection B. 6 and 10 outside. This is A intersection B. Common members of A and B. Now complement means leave this 3 and 5 and everything will be included in your complement. So what about left hand side? A intersection B complement, that is equal to universal A and B, 6, 10, 3, 5, 1, 7, 9, 2, 4, 8. Dear students, this is complement of A intersection B. complement of A intersection B. Everything included other than 3, 5. That is your left hand side. After that, what is A complement? A complement means universal minus A. Leave A from universal. So here is, leave A from universal. This is A complement. Leave A from the universal. What about B complement? Universal minus B. We will leave B from the universal. Here is your universal minus B. Universal minus B. From the universal, we subtracted B from this. Now, on right hand side is A complement union B complement. Remember that you have to combine them. Here is shaded, not shaded, but it will come in universal. This is shaded, this is not shaded, it will come in universal. But remember that in both A complement and B complement, they do not have 3 and 5. Except 3 and 5, everything will be shaded. And that will be your left hand side. So this is Venn diagram of De Morgan law, in fact. Except 3 and 5, that's your right hand side. Here, except 3 and 5 is your left hand side. So, left hand side is equal to right hand side. I hope that you understood this question. After that, we have question number exercise 5.4. And in exercise 5.4, you have seen question number 1, and exactly the same is question number 2. No difference at all. So after that, question number 3, you have already the same parts included. Now I am going to write down the question number 4 of exercise 5.4. Yes, exercise 5.4, question number 4. Question number 4 is, find the sets X and Y. You have to find the set X and Y. If X cross Y is given, this is AA, BA, CA, DA. AA, BA, CA, and DA. Dear students, you can check. In case of Cartesian product, all members of X are first members. Always. All members of X are first members, and all members of Y are the second members. So, what you will suggest from here? X is A, B, C, D, and Y is A, because it will be written only one time. You will not repeat in any set. So, dear student, that was your answer. That's your answer. Exercise. After that, if X equal to A, B, C, y equal to d e, then find the number of elements in y cross x and x cross x. Basically, you can see members elements of Cartesian product will be equal to the product of their numbers. For example, question number 5, x is ABC, y is DE. X is equal to ABC and y is DE. So the question is, find the number of elements in y cross x. Number of elements in y. How many? There are two. Number of elements in y, 1 and 2, 2 members. And number of elements in x, how many? There are 3, ABC. And number of elements in y cross x is equal to 2 by 3, that is 6. That is your answer. And remember that you can confirm from here. Look, AD, AE, 2, BD, BE, 4, CD, CE, 6. So we have 6 members. This is the way to find. After that, last time, we finished exercise 5.5 and question number 1 and 5 were given and we saw that. So, after this we have question number 2 and question number 6, part 7 and 8.
Second member set,
8 minus 2. So that's your answer. That's your question number 2. After that, question number 4. M has 5 members. We have to find the binary relations. Number of binary relations from any set, any Cartesian product, it will be written as 2 power A cross B members. 2 power A cross B members. So for example, question number 4, N has elements is equal to 5. M cross M has elements 5 into 5. Binary relations in M cross M, that will be 2 power 5 into 5. That is 2 power 25. This is your answer. That is the question number 4. After that, we have question number 6. In case of question number 6, we have to write down some properties. Before solving question number 6, we have to write down some properties of function. Dear students, be careful. Be careful to understand these things. What is meant by function? Remember that, suppose we have two sets A and B. This is a relation. If you want to find, if you want to check whether the function is not or what type of the function is, first of all, you will find A cross B. Cartesian product of A and B, you will find. After that, there are some certain properties. Number one is, you will choose R from here. From A cross B, you will choose R from here, and sometime this R will be given to you. So first is, R must be binary relation in A cross B. This is your first property, you have to check it. R must be binary relation in A cross B mean the members of R will always from A cross B. Second is, domain of R is equal to set A. That is domain, set A. Number 3, no first element is repeating. No first element is repeating. This is your third property. If any binary relation completes these three properties, then R is a function from A into B. This is the type of function into function. Then R is a function from A into B if three properties are satisfied. If first property, second, third, and the fourth property, that range of R is equal to set B. If four properties are satisfied, then R is a function from A onto B. Dear sir, the students, if R four properties are satisfied, then we have an onto function. If fifth property is satisfied along with into plus 1 to 1. 1 to 1 means no second element is repeating. Remember that in into function, in onto function, there was no property like the second function. But one-to-one function means no first, no second element is repeating. No second element is repeating. Then it will be known as one-to-one function. Dear students, if any function is into n plus 1 to 1, if any function is into plus 1 to 1, that is known as injective function. Injective function. If a function satisfies an into and 1 to 1, this is known as injective function. Remember that R2 is also known as surjective function. Remember that these are the names of the functions. Sometimes they are asking surjective, not onto. Then student may confuse what type of surjective is. Actually, it is onto. Injective function means into plus 1 to 1. And if we have onto plus 1 to 1, that is known as bijective function. Dear students, these are the properties which will be satisfied to make a function into, onto, injective, bijective. So after that, now we are able to start our part number 7 and 8. It is given in your revised review syllabus. Exercise 5.5, question number 6, 7th part. What is A? A is 1, 3, 5. Actually, it is R7. 1, 3, 5, and we have B. It will be PQRS. PQRS. Dear students, you can check what is R7. R7 is actually 1P, 3R, 5S. 1R. Yes, 1R, 3P. Okay, 1R, no problem. 3P, 1R, and 3S. So, what is bijective R7? We can write down 1R, 3P, and 5S. Number 1 is, I told you about this, first of all, you have to find A cross B. Cartesian product of A and B, that may be 1. Actually, our set A set is 1, 3, 5, and set B is PQRS. What about A cross B? A cross B is the Cartesian product 1P, 1Q, 1R, 1S. Then 3P, 3Q, 3R, and 3S. 5P, 5Q, 5R, and 5S. Dear students, what is your first property? What is your first property? First property is that R must be binary relation in A cross B. You can check the members of R. Are they present in A cross B? Yes. 1R is here. 3P is there. And 5S is at the last one. So these are the members taken from A cross B. They are present. So number 1 property is satisfied. You can write down R is a binary relation in A cross B. Number 1 satisfied. Domain of R is equal to, what is domain of R? First member set. 1, 3, 5. Here is 1, 3, 5. That is 1, 3, 5 equal to set A. Yes. After that, any first member is repeating or not? This is 1, this is 3, this is 5. No member is repeating. No first element is repeating. No first element is repeating. So up to here, R is an into function. Three properties satisfied. After that, you can check. Fourth property was range of R is set B. What is the range of R set B? R, P, S. R, P, S, Q is missing. Q is missing. So range is not equal to set B. Hence, what is that? It is into function. And along with this, check that if second element is repeating, R is coming one time, P is coming one time, S is coming one time. So, therefore, R is an into plus one-to-one function. Therefore, R is an injective function. Dear students, I think you understood about into, onto, one-to-one, and what is into plus one-to-one, injective, onto, one-to-one is bijective. So according to these properties, we have checked that R is a function from A into B plus one-to-one, that is injective function. I hope that you understood this question. And after this, we have part number 8. I am making part number 8 because we have only two parts in the syllabus, and I want to make you clear about the type of the functions, and maybe function or not, you can check it from this. Here is part number 8, R8. Here is set A and B, 1, 3, 5, 7, A, B, C, 1, 3, 5, 7, A, B, C. We have 1C, 3A, 1C, 3A, and 7B. Okay, 7B. What is R8? R8 is actually 1C, 3A, and 7B. Dear students, you can check A cross B, that is Cartesian product, that is 1A, 1B, 1C, 3A, 3B, 3C, 5A, 5B, 5C, 7A, 7B, 7C. This is Cartesian product. And you can easily check that yes, R8 is binary relation in A cross B. R8 is binary relation in A cross B. Number 2 is domain of R8. What is domain of R8? 1, 3, 7. Set of first member is known as domain. 1, 3, 7. 5 is missing. Is not equal to set A, therefore R8 is not a function. I told you that least number of characteristics or properties are 3. Less than 3, binary relation will not be a function. So that is finished. I hope that you understood this question. And dear students, we have finished our chapter number 5. And only chapter number 6 is left, and inshallah, in next lecture, I will finish this chapter number 6, and along with that, our syllabus, revised reduced syllabus, will be finished in this way. I hope that you may understand this question and write down these properties Maybe it is not written in this way in your book, but to understand the concept, these properties must be written in this way. You can write down the types of function or not. Okay, Allah Hafiz and Assalamu Alaikum.